Hello, darlings. Please don't forget to like, share, subscribe. If you're another YouTuber, let me know down in the comments, and I will sub you back. Now stay safe, get your boosters, and here's the video. Hello, darlings. It's Brandy here. Today, we are going to do our first set with the pre-spring products, these really cute ladybugs. But first... it's shameless promotion time. So here is some of the poppin' stuff that we have on the website. We have all these nail boxes. We have the metal slices. We have the updated nail piercing kit. And all super cute kawaii charms in all sizes and shapes. So please come check us out and place an order so that you don't miss out on some poppin' ass nails. I do want to apologize about the comments. I haven't really been responding, and that's a shitty thing for me to do. It just was hard getting everything ready for the rollout, and I'm still getting stuff ready. So, you know, my time is... I got to do better time management. That's all I'm going to say. But please keep leaving your comments, because I really do appreciate your input. It really means a lot. Okay, y'all, I started a Follow Friday post. It's a little lackluster at the moment, but I know it's going to snowball into something amazing. If you don't know what Follow Friday is, basically the way that I started it was I looked up hashtag Follow Friday because it did come up on a couple of people that I was already following. And then I just went through the thing, you know, like where you search, put hashtag Follow Friday and posts come up. And there's groups of people, there's like 3 or 4 groups that I know of that do this already. So I would just go drop my IG link handle, not link handle, you know, like at BRC Nails on these other people's posts, and people will come along and follow you and you just follow them back. So I decided to start one of my own because why not, right? So if you're interested, please let me know. I can add you to the list, and it's a single post, and you will get followers from it. And the longer it goes on, the more followers you will get. So if you're interested, let me know. You just post this on Friday. I have the text written out. You can make your own picture if you'd like. You can put your own text if you like even. But, you know, I wanted to make it easy for everyone. So like I said, if you're interested, let me know down in the comments. Now let's get on to this video. Okay, y'all, in my favorite go-to shimmery nude, there was, like, silver mylar in it. So it took me a long time to do the 2 coats of the nude for the French. I thought that I had filmed at least part of it, but I haven't. I've been really, really into Frenches lately, so I don't know why. It's just really coming to me with the Frenches, so... that's my little niche right now. I decided to go with the jelly colors to bring out, you know, the spring and brightness and happiness and all that stuff. And I was just taking a fuzzy off that with the toothpick. I dusted the other day, so there's like fuzzies everywhere. Now with these, I did put 2 coats of the jelly polish on there just to make sure that it wasn't too streaky and it gave a nice vibrant color. So an easy way to do a French is to take the nail, put a dot in the middle where you want the top to be, and then put 2 dots on either side as your lowest points, and then you connect the dots. You can do it V, you can do it round. If you were going to do it diagonal, I mean, you would put the dots, you know, in a diagonal line instead. So that way you're able to make an even, smile line with no muss and no fuss. Now, with jelly nails or any kind of transparent or semi-transparent nails that you do, you're going to want to make sure that you don't get any smudges underneath, because it's going to change the look and just make it look not as neat and clean as it should be and can be. So just keep that in mind as well. So I took my ambassador, Miss Stassi Fantasy, advice, and she told me to just put a nice little line of black to, you know, give it the border and clean up any little messes that might be there, because sometimes it's hard to get that really clean line. Even though you're trying, it just still ends up a little messy, so I usually put like glitter or stones or something on there. But these, you know, as I get better with my hand painting, you know, I can kind of step away from that and start moving on to other techniques where I don't really need to worry about it because I'm slowly getting better. I decided to use a 3D paint pot because there's a couple layers of the jelly and then there's two layers of the polish. So I felt like if I put regular polish, it wasn't gonna sync right with the other polishes. So I went with the 3D and I think they came out really, really good. I'm using a super, super fine brush because you can always go thicker. It's harder to go thinner evenly, but you know, handy dandy silicone tool can fix any mistakes that you might have. Dip it in some rubbing alcohol, blot it a little bit, and then you can just slide it up and even out your line if it's a little choppy. Okay, I didn't want to bore you with all that. Now, I'm trying to zoom in, but, you know, I have a really hard problem of keeping in the camera frame when I zoom in. But I wanted to show you how I put together a spinner. Now, I take the actual spinner itself, and I kind of buff both sides with my e-file so that when you put the drill gel glue or gummy jelly or, I mean, poly gel, I think, is just a little too sticky. Because you want to be careful you don't gunk up the mechanism that makes the spinner. So that's why I used a little toothpick to put the drill gel glue on there. And then I always give it test spins to see if it is even, like right in the right spot, or if it's like giving like an oval spin. Because like some things, it's really hard to get that balance right. Because, you know, it's top heavy or bottom heavy or what may have you. So I take my tweezers and I hold the bottom part of the spinner and the top part is loose. And, you know, I put the dot of the drill gel glue, I put the thing on it and then I test it. Then I whip out my little flashlight to flash cure it. And then I put it in the lamp and I put it in the lamp with the right side up first, and then I flip it upside down just to make sure, you know, that it's really, really on there. So it does take a little fiddling with, but we do have them in stock if you are interested. I only have a couple of sets of the spinners left, so if you want them, you need to get them now while you can. And I'm just putting the flashlight on there, making sure that it is semi cured. I do give it a little push down so that it's, you know, connecting with the spinner itself. You know, there's still the layer of adhesive there, the drill gel glue, but, you know, I want it to be firm. So on the other nails, I'm putting the color of the ladybug itself. You know, the jelly color matches the ladybug color. And I'm just using my drill gel glue and plopping it on there. I do put a generous amount so that it will hold the ladybug fast while I'm trying to get it into the lamp and in the right position, because sometimes, like, I know some people like to use the top coat, but it just doesn't really work as well for me, so I always go with the drill gel glue. See, I put a nice little dollop on there and it is fairly thick. And even on this one, I put it a little high, but I was able to move it down where I wanted to and still have a good amount of the drill gel glue on there. Now with applying the spinners, I still use the drill gel glue, but I use a smaller dollop of it because you don't want to gunk up the mechanism, because I don't even know if you could clean it out. Knock on wood, I haven't had a problem with it with these, but you know, I put a smaller dollop. I make sure it's where it needs to be because it's always moving, it's spinning. It makes it a little hard sometimes to get it centered and to make sure that it's centered. So, you know, I use the light again and then put it into curing the lamp. If you're still watching this video, please hit the like button, let your girl know you were here, leave a comment, and I promise I will answer it. I'm so sorry. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit the bell, because even if you're subscribed, you might miss future uploads if you don't have the bell on, because that's just how YouTube works. It's really not small creator friendly. And yeah, I have my little messes and mix-ups. Like, I just dropped that whole freaking ladybug. It just went ploop. So nothing is perfect. You know, you just got to kind of laugh it off and try to go with it. Okay, so this was the finished look originally. Yeah, see, look at those babies go. But I felt like something was missing. Like, I needed to add something. So, of course, I added piercings. Yes, yes. And now we have an updated kit. It's $8.99. You get a ring with it that helps you open jump rings if you only have one set of pliers. And then also we have some candy colored matte jump rings in addition to the metallic colored ones. So, you know, like I said, this spring and summer is going to be all about piercings and chains and dangles. And we got them all. Well, not the chains, but everything else. So please check out the website. If you do want to place an order, please use one of our ambassador codes. Save 10% using ShuriBaby10 or Sassy10. You know, save that coin on some dope-ass products. And I am telling you, ladies and gentlemen, I have the stuff to hook you up. It is coming. It is fire. And I'm already, this is just the preview. This is just the beginning, okay? So yes, definitely come check us out and use that code. One of them. Either one. And yeah, I think that's about it. Thanks so much for watching. Have a marvelous day. And thanks again. Mwah.